Hello, hello, welcome to the London vlog. So basically, last night we flew out of Chicago. We had an 8-hour flight to London. and we got in a couple hours ago. We Ubered to our hotel. Our hotel isn't ready for us to check in. Just our walking around, we just stopped at Leon. I'm pretty sure this is like popular fast food here, but I honestly know nothing. Ooh, chicken burger. It's 12:08 and we can't check in until 3 unless they like have our room ready early, which probably won't happen. So I honestly have no idea what we're gonna do.
We're just living.
Our luggage is at the hotel. I feel disgusting. I need to shower. I need to brush my teeth. I want to change. Interesting. Walked back to the hotel because Noah had to take a dookie.
Why you gotta do that?
We had to go to the bathroom. We didn't know where else to find a bathroom, so we just came back, and then we went to the bathroom, walked out of the bathroom, and the guy told us that our room is ready. So that's really good. It's only like 12:54, and I wanted to film a little first impression of our room. View. There's a little nook. I thought that was a bong.
It's so nice.
This is so cute.
I'm gonna take such bad shit.
Stop.
This
love
is
it.
Honestly, God, the nicest hotel bathroom I've ever been in.
Look how nice it is. This is so nice. Okay, I can't wait to shower and get ready. And then we can actually go enjoy London without feeling gross. You know how you feel after a flight? Take that and then do like, you skipped the entire night. Like, it was 8 hours. We skipped the entire night. Like, we didn't get to sleep, and now it's just the next day. Feeling okay, though. I'm not feeling super tired or anything. I just got a coffee, so hopefully that helps. We're gonna try not to sleep or anything today until tonight because it'll like mess up and like cause jet lag and stuff. So we're gonna shower. Okay, guys, it is currently 5:23. We took a little nap, like an hour nap. We're gonna try not to sleep or anything today. I know we said we weren't going to nap, but we desperately needed it. I haven't even had time to explain like what I'm doing. If you've been living under a rock and haven't seen any of my other content or like me talking about Europe at all, basically me and Noah, we're in Europe for like 3 weeks, and we're going to London, Paris, somewhere in Switzerland. I know where, but it's just like a little lake, Lugano. Venice, Florence, Rio Maggiore, and then Rome.
This is all the makeup that I packed for this trip, which is highly impressive because if you guys know me, I usually bring like, I mean, I don't know if you would know this, but I don't know. I'm delusional. I usually bring this fat pink makeup bag, but I was able to get everything in there.
While we were taking a nap, they dropped this little plate off.
I'm scared.
I have no idea what it is. It's probably like little chocolate things. I'm doing my makeup right now. I've realized that I forgot my beauty blender and setting spray so far. So hopefully those are the only two things that I forgot, because otherwise I'll be highly disappointed in myself. Okay, guys, I finished my makeup and I put on all my accessories and jewelry and stuff, and I put on this outfit. Pretty casual, but still cute, I would say. I have no idea what we're doing really for dinner. We're going to Soho, but I don't know like what type of restaurant we're gonna be able to like find or get into or whatever.
The room looks so pretty right now. Like the lighting, I love it. Here's the current view. The sun is setting. So pretty. Okay, we're gonna go leave. I keep doing the peace sign. We're gonna go walk downstairs and leave. Okay, we found a restaurant after 30 minutes of walking around. Or 45 minutes. We ordered and got our food in literally 5 minutes.
It looks so good.
First
real meal in London.
So basically, one of my favorite pastas, like sauces at home, is the Rayos Abba. Don't know how to say it. They have like this one here. We just left dinner and we stopped at a little like speakeasy 1940s inspired bar thing. But we're just in, what is this place called? Kingsley Court. And it's super cute. It's just like a little, I don't know, like kind of looks like a market area. We walked around for so long trying to find exact. They whip
those things. We walked around for so long looking at all of the menus, because like all of the menus are posted outside the doors of like the restaurants. We looked at so many different menus and we couldn't decide. Pasta sounded really good, but we just like couldn't find a place that we wanted to go to. And then we found a place that looked really good, but there were so many people in there and we just didn't want to wait. So we just kept walking, and then we stumbled across Spaghetti House, and there was like barely anybody in there. And I think it was a sign, because the pasta that I got, I tried to explain it in there. I don't know if you could hear me. It was like a more authentic version of my favorite pasta that I always make at home, which is just like already like in the jar, whatever. There's so many cool shoe stores here. This one called Size. Actually, it's not called Size. It's called Size? Why is there a question mark?
I just can't get over how cool this is. Everything is so pretty.
We got ready for the day and we're just gonna go have breakfast up at like the rooftop, or not the rooftop restaurant, but like the one below the rooftop. Here's the breakfast fit. I'm gonna change later and we're running late. I curled my hair. I got like the right plug converter thing so I could use my American curling iron, but it smelled like it was burning. So we'll see what happens to that.
This looks so delicious.
We got our food, it was pretty fast. I got the waffles with like mixed fruit just because I'm such a waffle girly. Waffles always sound good and these look so good.
Noah got the, what did you get?
Like a chorizo bowl.
Chorizo bowl with potatoes and stuff. It looks so good. Can I please try your?
Pretty good bread.
Okay, you guys, I've eaten a majority of this. I'm gonna eat probably another one of these, but I'm getting pretty full, so I don't know if I'll be able to finish both. Yesterday when we got that chocolate plate delivered, they gave us one of these, and I thought it was a tomato.
Maybe I'm just like super stupid and uncultured, but I don't know what this is, and I'm going to try it for you guys. It just looks like an orange tomato. The weirdest thing I've ever tasted. It's like spicy fruit.
So we just walked like 15 minutes and we're at like Chinatown, I think. We're just gonna walk around and maybe like try some different food and stuff. But yeah, look at this. I like him. We walked to a little bakery and we're gonna see how it is. I think that's the stuff she was talking about.
Thank you.
Look at it.
Is it just like regular cake, kind of?
Vanilla cake?
That's pretty good. He fucking that shit up.
Okay, we just walked to Buckingham Palace just to see it. Super cool, super pretty. I feel delusional right now. That corn dog though is really good. Could go for another one. Big Ben. Big Ben. Big Ben.
Oh yeah, he's getting the angles, getting all the angles for the tourists. Oh yeah.
We're on our way back. I have no idea what's behind us. Drop it in the comments. I'm getting hungry and I want to go back to Chinatown and get an egg roll because I really wanted one. And then we saw those corn dog things, so we did that instead. But I want an egg roll.
Shut up.
Okay, Okay, you guys, we stopped at Farmer J on the way back.
We were trying to walk back to Chinatown and stop and get... Oh, I thought my sweatshirt was on backwards. We tried to stop and get sushi and egg rolls somewhere, but when we put it in the maps, we realized we were like 12 minutes past it. Like, we had walked too far and it just like wasn't worth it to go back. So we knew that this place and there was like another sushi place right by our hotel, but the other sushi place was like pre-packaged sushi. It was like fast food sushi and that did not sound good. So we went to this place, which I never heard of, but yesterday when we were walking past it, there was a line out the door. So I assume it's pretty popular here,
but it's basically kind of reminds me of like Chipotle in a way, in the sense that you kind of pick out what you want and like build your own thing. You pick like your main and then you pick two sides. Looks pretty good.
That's pretty good. Your cauliflower is really good. This is really good.
Okay, guys, we didn't accidentally fall asleep. We meant to fall asleep, but we accidentally slept a little longer. So the night, we're exhausted. It is currently 10:28 and we slept until about 9 and we've just been like laying in bed. I don't want anybody to come at me and be like, you're wasting your time, because we are going to be traveling Europe for 24 days. I don't know, 22 days. And if we go every single day, like from morning till night, we're going to literally die. So I feel like today was a successful day. We did a bunch and now we're going to walk and get gelato at some place that's really close by. Noah mentioned ice cream and it sounds good, so I'm down.
Okay, we just walked like 5 minutes to where the gelato place is supposed to be, and it's just like a closed down thing. So it doesn't exist, it's not open, it doesn't reside there anymore. So we're walking to this McDonald's that's like right here, which I know, like, oh, you're getting McDonald's in another country. Yeah, I am.
Most people don't need ice.
Well, we got ice.
Okay, guys, we just got back to the hotel. We ate our ice cream on the way. I got the Maltesers McFlurry. It's like the mini one. It was pretty good. Noah got the Cadbury limited time McFlurry. We got a cheeseburger and the dollar or pound, pound of the day. Pound 19 of the day wrap, and it's the chili crispy chicken wrap. Noah got a cheeseburger and the Caesar chicken wrap. I'm gonna try the cheeseburger first. We just wanna get the cheeseburger to see if there was any difference. Yeah, it tastes the same. I'm gonna try the wrap now. It's been so long since I've had a wrap from McDonald's. The chicken's really good.
You know when we did that Burger King thing? That's what the ad looked like it was gonna be like. They literally might have used these wraps in that commercial.
Good morning! It is day 3 in London. It's our final day. We leave tomorrow. Today we are walking to like Covent Garden and like Neil's Yard. I guess Neil's Yard is in Covent Garden. But we're walking that way and then we're gonna take the tube to like East London City. I don't really know how I don't know the right phrase, like terminology to use, but we're going to see like London Bridge today and like probably the Tower of London and just some other like touristy things over on that side of town. So I'll see you guys when we get outside. We woke up this morning and there's loud construction happening. If you can hear this, it was like 5 times worse right when we woke up. I'm literally wearing the same outfit that I wore 2 nights ago, but I'm wearing it with sneakers instead of boots. I'm wearing this because I don't want to dig stuff out of my suitcase, and also I don't have that many like warm options. I have like 3 sweaters and then 2 jackets, and I really like this outfit and I didn't get a picture in it, so we're just gonna wear it again. Fit check. Oh yeah,
it's a wee bit wrinkled.
It's fine. You're the only person that cares about wrinkles.
Noah just asked for ice water. They don't do ice water here, but they gave us some.
I got a latte. Looks delicious. Okay, we walked like 5 minutes and now we're at the actual like Covent Garden market, and we're gonna go inside and see how it is.
We just left like Covent Garden and we're going to St. Paul's Cathedral, which is a big church, right? I don't know, it's like a 20-minute walk. We were gonna take the train, or the tube. We've decided to just take a stroll instead. And it's pretty out here.
come here.
So pretty, it's fun.
Look at that.
The iPad.
We pray for the church throughout the world and for the life of this cathedral.
Somehow we've decided to walk everywhere today. We're walking to the London Bridge right now, which is, we're like probably an hour 20 walk away from our hotel right now, so we're definitely gonna take the tube back. But yeah, so far the day is good. My feet don't hurt, even though we've been walking hella. So we're on London Bridge. I don't know what, I thought it was that one. Tower Bridge. We learned that's Tower Bridge. This looks like every other bridge.
Chocolate covered strawberries, and they are definitely worth the hype. They're so good. It's the sweetest strawberries ever. This chocolate is so good.
Rose, please save some for me. Please.
Check out your own.
Hey guys, it's like 8 p.m. right now. We went back to the hotel. and I've been editing for like a while. I've been editing like Instagram pictures and also a YouTube video that I have to have up in a few days. And then Noah took a little nap. Here's the outfit. Ew, my pants look so weird. I don't even care. Here's the outfit. It's kind of ugly.
Got some gelato. Thank you, Noah. Thank you. Thank you.
Noah told me to check out the bathroom because he wasn't expecting it to be the way that it was. And now we're heading down a bunch of stairs. Wow, a bunch of stairs. How many stairs?
That's what's so weird about
it. Hello, you guys. We're back at our hotel. We've been here for a while since I saw you last at dinner. Pizza was pretty good. I rate it like an 8 out of 10.
7.
7 out of 10? Yes.
8 is like fucking holy shit.
Yeah. The gelato we got was good. The bathroom was strange. Came back here, started packing up our stuff because we leave London tomorrow morning. And then I showered and we're about to go to sleep. So I figured this is the perfect time to close off the London vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you didn't, you're kind of out of luck because you're only gonna be getting fucking travel vlogs for the next 6 weeks. Oh, I forgot to say, after we got back to our hotel too, we started freaking out about the Paris bed bug issue, if you guys know what's going on with that. Basically, Paris is infested with bed bugs, and I'm hoping that it isn't as bad as it sounds. But apparently, they're like all in the trains and like the metro and like hotels and Airbnbs and movie theaters and everything like that. We're gonna be extremely careful. We've thought, like, we were literally at the point where we're like, can we like call and like cancel this trip and like go to Switzerland or some shit instead? And it's just too late to do that. And if we did, you know, decide to go somewhere else, we'd be out probably like, I don't know, the hotel was probably like $1,500. The train or the Eurostar there is like $500. Like, we'd be out a shit ton of money, and it's just like, I don't know. I guess tune into next week's vlog to see how Paris goes and how the bed bug
war ends up. I love you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.